Okay, so I'm still not entirely sure which way I'm going to go with the material. With the like for the multiple sub resource thing. I mean, I have a good idea. I'm probably going to do like a pnext struct, much like in Vulkan, but I'm not entirely on board with it yet, or it hasn't really formulated or finished baking in my mind yet. So I'm going to take a nice little bit of a sidetrack, and I'm going to see if I can resourceify the vertex descriptor or some very basic form of it, so I don't have to hard code it like I do here. Which should also mean I can get rid of the last of the vestigial shader code from the actual main application, like this original stuff, which is basically nothing. But hey, it's something. It's something. So let's start. Vertex. Where we all start. I'll actually base it off fragment descriptor, which makes a bit more sense in this case. Sorry. At least, no, I know I'll at least want this vertex descriptor, which I think is under the graphics Vulkan graphics VK. Yes, nomenclature still. Does use faux shader? Does it use? And we'll of course have a text descriptor loader eventually. So this is pretty much the same stuff here. Vertex descriptor loader. Graphics VK vertex descriptor. Yes. Oh, I don't have a source aside. So this isn't even being loaded, so it doesn't actually have a basis for how to get the information yet. Okay. The wrong file name. Okay. It should mean if I come back in here, now it's going to find everything. So we're going to be friend class, the loader type. We have the general items. Yes, we have the specialization. How do I const this? I probably shouldn't. I should be able to update the loader later. data write lock, which is still a terrible idea as it stands. Subresources. We're going to need a substruct for subresources. That is for sure. Because going back to this, move it over. We have several things. We have like the vertex shader. We have four shader types. Amazing. So those are the things. We sub resources loading, the loading ones. Then we're going to have the actual data, the active data basically, which is sub resources associated with the active one. Which is for now going to be that. Okay. Is there even anything here that... Not really. This is all just... This is all just sitting right there, basically. You know what? I will... There we go. It's in line or on the, it's in the struct. Which means, oh yeah. Oh no, I already have the entire thing declared in there, so I can do that. Okay. So fragment descriptor. What are the vertex descriptor? What we got? We got this. These are all the same. Ah, yes. I'm also going to need the vertex descriptor loader. This one right nice and fast, since it's basically this copied over almost verbatim again. Okay. Just a little thing on the header. Just a happy little accident. Share mutex, we got this. Okay. Vertex descriptor loader. Okay. Go to the loader. Again, the loader will be very close to the same as this. Yes, yes. Nope. Yes, yes, yes. Frag. Okay, when we go back down to Vertex Descriptor. We need that include. Plus, what else we need from here? Log and the shader. Same. Basically, the whole thing's just about the same, except for the last two, getting fragment and whatever the shaders. Request resources load and unload for the vertex descriptor, which does make sense. Okay. Do I have up in the YAML world? I do not have vertex descriptor here. Do I have any of the other types? Okay, what are exactly for the vertex descriptor? Don't care about the pool, don't care about the loader. This, do I have, let's say this? No, I do not, not yet. Okay, let's start from the beginning and work our way back. So in here, IMX include. No, I'm not doing that. Doing this, copying this around, pasting that. We're not entirely sure on that quite yet. We'll figure it out soon. Focus on exporting first, it's always easier, then we'll re-import, which is the hard part. Okay, I'm just going to delete this folder because it keeps annoying me. Despite the fact it takes forever. I don't really need to have the header. I could just put it all in here. I'll keep the others there what they are, because whatever. Or do I really want to? Yeah. So what we got? Including that, which is the vertex one. Got that. These two, then F stream. We'll do this one first. Where we are exporting it. Lovely days. Sure on that. Try. What we'll do is the definition, write the YAML descriptor definition. Be on the same node, definition, or sorry, vertex descriptor definition node with the usual try and stuff, and then we spit it out to file. Okay. Really? Oh, because he included it. Cute. Go to declaration, which is this. Go in, we have the right node, we have this preamble, then we got this stuff for the after amble, post amble. Okay, if p vertex descriptor, right now I can't get any of the sub resources out. Not pretty, not pretty. What's it called? Is it called? Isn't it just called data? Nope, not what I'm looking for. Oh, I don't even have it here. Data dot loaded dot. Dot p vertex. tessellation control, evaluation, all this stuff. So we got those guys. Now we can flip back to here. All right, the vertex descriptor definition, which goes back up here. If this get, do I have? I do have it. Bullied about the constness of these. My apologies. Program. Okay. If has res node, then right node. Actually, you know what? Whatever. Who cares? Always write it anyways. Two, three, four. So get. Ah, yes, this is why they are privatized like that. Because someone down the line is going to want the declarations and stuff of these. So sub resources, now I need to go into the graphics data. just return that. Okay, we come back to here, we're just gonna return get this would, of course, roll back into the Vulcan section, which means Vertex descriptor. No class. I ain't got no class. Not here. Bam. Well, that's what we're doing first, is we're writing it out, so. Okay, what we got? Not here, I'm looking for the Vulcan guy. There you are. Okay, input assembly is by itself. Tessellation SCI is itself. Vertex input, it takes these guys. So we'll do Vertex input SCI first. What's inside of here? Is it just those other two types brought in? Plus flags. Do I have this even added to... Doesn't even look like it. Nope. So we'll do that. Will we? Yes, we will. Okay. No, not resource. Not that. Not that. Not that. Not that. Just close everything to the right, okay? Because that's the thing I was looking for. Oh, on the very left. Pipeline vertex, blah, 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 is not even here. So we're going to go, we're going to find the declaration of it inside the Vulcan core, which is this right here. I'm going to slap that into here. We're going to, we don't do this type, we don't do that, but we'll do flags. Not that, not that, not that, not that. These would do manually. Blend color, color blend state, SCI. We do do that, and then we do the attachments separately. I need to actually come up with a better system for this. Now I have to manually specify here, which is not that great. Okay, if, well, this has a thing like if it has the color blend SCI. Input node. Data. YAML write optional. Should be this. VK. This. If it's blank, don't write it in. Compare that against the P vertex descriptor. Vertex input SCI. Sorry. Okay, that's something I'm going to have to think of. I'm going to have to think real hard on that. Put node. Okay, we got that. We will now do... input bindings, then we'll do input attachments, input attributes. Go through each of those, and then we'll it just it's always right being written, okay? Damn it. Attributes. Okay, I need to grab from Vertex Descriptor. I need to grab this node and the attribute ones. I need to grab them, copy them, and then I'm going to Vertex input binding description. This is something that'll be abstracted away someday, I'm pretty sure. Pretty sure, but not 100%. Add these guys here. Okay, what else we got? We got the pipeline input creation info stuff. Clang decided to crash now, which is not what I wanted. I hate this language server thing. Or the fact that it crashes all the time. And pipeline tessellation state info create stuff. Just these things. I don't know what they do, but there you go. I need to go to libsfographics. Libs YAML tools. YAML struct generate. For VK structs. TXT. Okay, I just need to slightly update this so that, like, if whatever argon. If $1. If it's an empty string, then whoops. I'm sorry, can I do something now? Oh my God. Then okay. Now what was I? I was doing all copy all this in to struct parsing, which starts from here, goes to the end, gives us a solid enough new chunk of stuff. This file, libs source vertex descriptor cpp, which would be right here. Cannot find. Oh, the faux resource one. Okay, well, at least I had that new file, though all these guys seem to be working. Plainly enough. Or at least it's not. Okay, yeah. YAML. Okay, back to the graphics YAML. Vertex descriptor. We got the vertex node input stuff, so we move back to the left. Close those to the right. Close that. got to go through the other two. So we got that. It's always true when it comes through here. It's always writing something out from these guys, at least for the moment anyways. And then otherwise we just, is there anything special going on with these guys? No funny business. How do I even determine if it has depends on if it has one of those. Okay, so I can do I guess input assembly is always required. I guess. So yeah, data written is always true. So we'll YAML. That. All right, I need a loader stuff. Initialization, deinitialize, initialize, process unload, request resource load, request resource unload. So this is standard stuff. Okay. The load resource will be just using what we have currently in the main application. Okay. Right. Sub resource type as well. So I'm going to say new subresources dot p vertex equals I need a thing for it. Do I even have it for this type? I don't see it, no. Okay. The spur V source, I need the graphics data, which is this stuff. Okay. So dang it. Vert shader, graphics data, it's gonna have. I think I have one around here somewhere. No. Like this. Oh, I already have it. It's the shader 2. Oh! Okay. Don't save it. So I don't actually have to do what I was about to do. That's great. I can come back to the loader. Come on down here. Nope, forward. Dang it. The shader 2. Do that. Here. New sub-resources. Just frickin'. Save myself a bit of trouble. Comes dot p vertex. Whoop. That. Okay. Create the resource. So what P So for this, we go to application, we get these items. Set these. Equals Okay, back to vertex descriptors, subresources. I need the functions for this. Will sneak from the fragment descriptor, I guess. At the moment, which will be these guys. So that means I need a vertex descriptor subresource. Fizz. Okay. Don't quite have one for this. Undefined reference to that. Tessellation, state create info. Really? For graphics YAML. Did I not add it? Pipeline, tessellation, state create info. It's right there. It's on the end. Right? So it should be one of the last ones in here. Input assembly state. Ah, it's not. Input assembly state create info. Okay, yeah. Did I save it or something? Input assembly and tessellation. Or do I just need to add an empty line on the end? Input assembly, tessellation. I was missing a line at the end. Classic. I'm definitely feeling a refactoring requirement for the resources. Not a full rework. I like a lot of what I have, but there's still some janky aspects that I'm not liking. That now that I have like several types developed, there's some serious shortcomings I need to address before I start expanding it beyond this last vertex thing. I'm not sure if I'll do that first or I'll finish up material. We'll see. Got everything links up. Fantastic. So what's going to happen now is application HPP. We're going to get some more resources. First of all, we're not going to do the pool. It'll just be that. Actually, not even that. That. Okay, we need the add it to loading and the init and dinit areas. So for frag right about here. We don't need that. We do need the others. Run on down and deinitialize. Great. Now we go to vertex. Here we go around here. current use count. That's done in a subthread, so I should be able to hit F5, come into here somewhere, have a quick look around. Because right now I'm not loading from file. Whoops. Where did I come in? I came in from here. Really? What went on? I'm moving these guys around. That's great. Okay, going to the reset. If null pointer. Yep. Because I don't. Do this to start with. Hey. Sorry. What? Okay, we start with, there's nothing in here. Nothing in here, guys. Nothing. Great. Is it because this one? Ooh, is this one not null pointer? To start with. It probably isn't, right? This data subresources has garbage data. But wait, hold on. How's this heck got garbage data? This is blank, so this should also be blank, which means this will be blank. I don't understand what's going on. Okay, loading is blank. Data is also blank. Name is blank. What? How is name blank? How am I blank? There's only one that's ever created right now, and it's in the application. Did I add one that's like on the stack like a dumbass? Yeah. No wonder. Okay. The vertex descriptor. Behold, behold. Amazing. Amazing. Now becomes expected, which is unloaded. Like, yeah, and this loading mechanism is not quite where I wanted it to be. Okay, so let's say we come back through. We do come back through. We do have the same stuff as before. We do put this data in. That. The data in, swap it out for the old stuff. The old stuff moves out. Okay. That's sitting in the corner. It's using the image. Great. Okay. Where do we have? Where do we use this? Oh. Yep, amazing. No, we just want to use that, please. So we have it there. Get ver graphics vertex descriptor. This is the pointers of that. Can I? Okay, that's on the OpenXR side. So let's actually try it on the non-XR side first. Cannot initialize value of this with that. Huh. Interesting. Because it's based on the pointer of the object for the moment. Ooh. Now, that's okay right now because it's not so bad for the fragment descriptor because that's kind of hidden in the private system, but for Vertex, I don't have that in place yet. That's unfortunate. Okay. Sorry, who did I modify then? I removed the wrong. Oh, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Okay. Const, const. It's fine. Const, const. Do that. We move back to the pipeline pool. We'll modify the pipeline pool. That's fine. Get pipeline. I'm going to go here. We know do const of that. That's not const. Okay, time for super naughty business. Const cast. I don't care anymore. Just a plain old, oh look, it's not a constant fucking pointer anymore, guys. It's all good. It's all good. Okay. Okay, this allows us to get rid of the old original vertex descriptor. From here. That means we also don't need these two anymore, vertex or fragment shader in the application. Get rid of these. Get rid of this stuff. Also, I need to make sure that this is actually. Make sure it's actually there for the moment. Just in case it's not loading right away, which is a very possible thing. All the original vertex descriptor stuff is gone away. Okay, there's a lot of stuff here. That also means I'd no longer require that shader file there. Okay, let's write out this to a file on exit. I'm actually fine with not deleting one of these, I guess. I need to figure that out. Yeah, okay. Just thinking of too much stuff. So we need a node, root node. Well, that's importing. I need to export. Need a definition. Do do. Export. I'll just do this. Three lines. It's done. Don't care. Wait, no, it's already going to be doing that, right? To the file specified in the. Yeah. So run this. Abort. Save all this. We don't need this anymore. Correct. Few less lines. Command out. And then we got this new file, which has got the resources, the shader 2, graphics data, no bindings, no attributes, input assembly is triangle strip. I mean, yeah. Yeah. Okay, hour 40, I'm running low on energy. Let's see. Grab a bit of a drink, be right back. Okay. Da-da-da. Need to import from file now. So time to do the opposite. Just close all. Close all to the right. Close that one. Close that one. Close that one. Okay. Doing that here. What we will have, though, is one, two, three, four. No, we also have those, the shaders. No, the shaders aren't brought by the graphics data. This is for everything else. What's it doing? It's already going all over the place for pointers, isn't it? Yeah. Okay, we have three things. We have vertex, we have this. We have this type node. Do you want to do it as a subnode? Yeah, I mean, I guess. We read this, right? Or do we read it as a subtype? No, we read that. It's a node and then type, data type, okay. If we have this, then we've got to go through for all of them. So no, iterator. Iterator. Iterate up. We say what VK, what is it? This. Put it on there. We're going to do the same thing. Input. So that was input bindings. The input attributes, very similar business. Do that instead. It's input attributes. And we're done with this node, then we back out, then we gotta go on to, what was it? Input assembly. And then tessellation, right? And then like this, I would also have to do these things. So input assembly, dot this type equals okay, we got that. We can now move back out. So we need these. They're basically all these items. So we've got these items that we have. What's standard? Vertex descriptor name for the file we're looking at. All right, then we got to go into the YAML. Pass all these in as well. Hmm. And I gotta do this bit. It is a bool. Okay. Two hours, okay. Sorry, no, we're importing. Get a Vertex descriptor loader. We're going in here. So much like this, it'll be basically this, comma, starting with P vertex descriptor, get name. the vertex descriptor will become we already have that up there. The input assembly becomes m tessellation. Tell me that it looks okay. Okay, whatever. We got the vertex shader, we don't. Oh, yeah, and I've got to check for sub resources. All of them. That's garbage data. I do need to reset it when I'm inside. Or I need to fix. Come back through again. Okay. I'll call it good enough for vertex descriptors then, right there. A good portion, but not quite all of it. Let's double back into application. Close all that. Goodbye, goodbye, goodbye. Down application. We're going with the pool now. Always after. Right, that's what we call it up here somewhere. The vertex descriptor. You got it. And we're gonna do it again down here. Super huge issues. Let's check it with validation on. That is really bad. But that's from something else. Interesting. It's like they're not being reset. Okay, when I reset, descriptor pool. Okay, that's great. See, what's going on in here is we are coming through and we are resetting VK. And then we are starting to allocate it from there, or just right after. So I don't understand why I would not think. Something I'm missing when I create it, like can I not reset it because I forgot a flag? No. I reset the pool. That's the first thing I did. Okay. I don't even have anyone I start. No, I have the wrong type. Yeah, I mean, okay. Obviously the implementation kind of, dodged my moronic programming here to actually still give out stuff, but. availability for materials. Same size. This is 40 lines, less than that, 20 lines gone. Shrunk by one line. Leave that there, and then I guess I'll call it on that. And then I got a bunch of other things to do, so I'll call it there. Cheers.